let us all that we can to build a better future.
Let's move on to our final story. Daniel, you got a story for the people. What is going on?
Okay, so without really trying to, I decided to pick up on a bunch of economists today, though I'm not sure I'm doing anything all that wrong, because they are talking a lot today, and they decide, you know, this is how we should rule the world. Is it the most efficient way under our models and beep-beep-doo? Okay, so let's talk about this. The economy as we know it might be over, says the Fed chairman. I mean, you could have asked us, like, ever, and we would have
really, they set, think that it's over? Okay,
well, no, no,
great.
As we know it.
As we know, oh.
Yeah. And we would have said, yeah, that's sort of been the problem for a while, is that it's working in, like, a 1916 mindset where all roads go to Rome and we're all Roman, except none of those things are true except the Roman robes that still exist. Anyway, the pandemic has accelerated existing trends in the economy and society, including the increase. You'll see a lot of connections with the previous story. A lot of technology, telework, and automation. This will have long-lasting effects on how people live and work. God, you don't say, like, things that have been said for decades, the economists are like, now I understand it, so it's official. While technological advances are generally positive for societies over the long term, Powell said, on the short term basis, they create disruption, which, of course, we shouldn't do anything about. And as markets adjust to the new, by the way, if you're an economist and you've just realized this, you should retire immediately. I'm just putting it out there. Because that's really pathetic if you're like, I just figured this out. Things are different. For example, it's likely to lower paid workers as well as those in jobs requiring face-to-face interactions such as retail or restaurant workers will shoulder most of the burden. Where have they been for the last like year, 10 years? I don't know. Ever. It's like, how do you like, I feel like if you put out something like what I'm reading, you're like, you have to retire. At least in the safest way possible, because you shouldn't be working if you've just figured this out. These groups, heavily skewed towards women and minorities, have already been among the most affected by the layoffs. Man, it's almost like women and minorities have, for quite a while, been in that category of description, not just now. Huh. Fascinating. The post-pandemic economy is also at risk of being less productive because women are being forced to quit their jobs due to childcare responsibilities. You could also do like childcare, a lot more jobs. Women go back to workforce. You're happy. We're happy. Kids happy. Everyone's happy. And children aren't getting the education they deserve. Also, where have you been in the last 100 years, 60 years? 40 years, 20 years, to now, again, retire. What are you saying? You're saying every stuff that everyone knows. By the way, did you know? Do you cool down water enough? Get solid.
Wait, did whoa, you know whoa, that? Whoa, 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 whoa.
Yeah.
You mean liquid can become a solid?
Yes. Did you know that? I just discovered that. Hey, gave me a Nobel Prize.
Hey. So the next thing you're going to tell me that it can also become a gas. Get out of here.
I haven't confirmed that yet, but I'm still working on it. I will get back to you in about 20 years to win another Nobel Prize on that subject.
Yeah, a liquid become a solid, then becoming a gas. Yeah, right, science. You don't know nothing and not know B.
Yeah, exactly. So generally speaking, inequality holds the economy back. The central banker said, the central banker who has perpetuated said inequality perhaps more than any other person on the planet, is saying that inequality holds the economy back. I'm trying really hard not to curse. I'm trying really hard. You'll hear the Chicago come out of me. It's when we start telling people they're going to have some nice long sleeps underwater. even after the unemployment rate goes down, there's a vaccine. There's going to be probably a substantial group of workers who are going to need support. By the way, again, yeah, people have needed support for a while. That's sort of part of the purpose of what we do is to, like, I don't know. Maybe they just saw Hard Lens Media for the first time. They're like, oh, I get it now. Duh, we help regular people. Oh, I didn't realize. This is just stupid. How are the smartest people sometimes the stupidest? Anyway, so there's going to be a probability substantial group of workers who are going to need support because it's going to be different in some fundamental ways. It doesn't even sound like they know what fundamental ways. Like, we could probably help them. Like, hey, Fed, can you just, like, bring us in for, like, a Q&A? We'll help you out. Washington has spent trillions of dollars to boost the economy. No, that's also not true. To boost the wealthy, a $1,200 check doesn't count in the long term, even though, to be fair to Trump, it's the most of a bailout that we've ever gotten in a pandemic, which is another sad thing. But they probably are going to figure that out in 20 years. There's going to be an article that's like, you know, when you do when you help the people, it's like you should do it on an ongoing basis.
You know, I can't help but think of the, because I want you to finish this article, but I just got to bring this analogy, because this author and this, you know, you have this, you know, Fed, what's the name of the gentleman who's talking about, like, how the economy we know is no longer going
to be. Okay, let me just pull back to this page. I believe it's pronounced old geezer.
Okay, so yeah. So this old bag is now making this prediction. And it's just like, he reminds me of a character from the movie Casino. It's a very subtle scene where, you know, Joe Pesci's character comes up to him and says, hey, I'm collecting my money. Because, again, Casino is about the mob in Las Vegas. And no matter what, the mob is always going to collect, right?
Yeah, Chicago mob still beats other mobs.
Right, And the thing is, like, the one guy who's supposed to run the money says, but you lost. I'm confused. And, like, Joe Pesci's character says, if you don't give me my money, I'm putting your head through the wall right there. And of course, he gives him the money, and Joe Pesci's sidekick character says, hey, buddy, you better smarten up next time.
Yeah. By the way, here's a crazy thing to throw in for these economists if they're listening, since they clearly just started watching the show. Cancel daylight saving time. You'll save about $20 billion a year and a couple hundred suicides. You don't have to do anything else but do that. Small things, big effect. Boom. Right.
And the thing is, if I were to ever run the office, especially for presidency, that's the one thing I'm making illegal. We are never reinstating daylight savings times, ever. That's illegal under penalty of torture. There we go.
So I just want to really quickly jump back to the pay tax that they were talking about in the previous story. These geniuses that said it was $48 billion per year. Again, canceling daylight savings times gets you a third of that. Not doing anything else but canceling daylight. They're really dumb.
Even the Germans that created it no longer do it.
Yeah, it only worked when the electricity was new. And anyway, we're getting way off topic. Let me finish this. See, look at this. We're getting into economy because someone has to, and it clearly isn't the people we're reading about. So, yeah, but jobless workers are still in a tough spot. Some benefits have already dwindled. Some. Again, every other word with this article there's an issue with. I have to start doing hand-cutting operations. More are set to expire at year-end. Economists are hopeful that the next administration, i.e. Biden, will manage to pass another stimulus bill or check. It'd be really funny if Trump had gotten his way and all the existing checks had, like, his letterhead on it. And they're like, we don't want to get new ones, so they send out Trump checks again anyway.
You know, I mean.
But anyway, economists are hopeful that the next will pass another stimulus bill that will help workers and businesses as the recovery continues. What do you mean continues? It's about to get worse. It continues to get worse. It's more precarious. Who, you know what, Kit?
What's up, buddy?
I'm going to have to follow a tried and true method of you, but I am stealing it because I'm very upset with these people that say that they know what's happening.
Well done.
They have no idea what's going on.
Very good. Very good. There we go. There we go. See? See what I mean? Well done. Well done, Dan. Come on.
You got to
rip the paper. Come on. We are live. Come on. Nancy was able to do it.
Hey, she hit one piece of paper in half.
I know, but for her, that was a feat of strength. Like,
here, tear this in half.
No, I don't think
that's
so.
That's what I thought.
That's what I thought. Because the more you rip apart paper, the stronger it does.
Oh, okay, now I see where that goes.
I listen to the scientists, folks.
Again, we're following a trend. Democrats increasingly, especially extreme centrists, not fans of math or science.
Yeah, extreme centrists. And here's the thing. Hashtag use it. Hashtag extreme centrist for these corporate Democrats, for these neoliberal blue checkmark people, for the brunch crowd that are obviously going to go to brunch because they're turning a blind eye to environmental disasters, police brutality, political corruption. Because I think really, in the long run, Trump made them feel uncomfortable. Look, here's the thing. Trump should never have been president in 2016. And, you know, look, I don't – if things continue to play out as they are and he bungles this whole election recount, which I know he probably will, look – he said some uncomfortable things, but that's all he did, really. And the guy was a buffoon and a clown and an idiot. And, you know, the establishment Democrats created that monster. Corporate media created that monster.